concert. So a lot of you are wondering, why am I like this? Why am I wearing a mask, and why am I drinking scotch, and why am I here by myself? So let me take off the mask and let me talk to you for a minute. So as you recall, we were supposed to do a beautiful concert with Julie Rumert and the famous David Warwick and a band and an amazing harp player Phoebe Powell coming in, and everyone from New York City, and we had all these rehearsals, and the grand piano was on its way, and along came the coronavirus. And since this virus happened, we've been we've all stuck at home, and I thought, well, maybe, you know, I would come in here by myself and have a drink and complain to you a little bit, to talk to you and complain and say, you know, like, it's been very rough for a lot of us sitting at home and trying to wallow in our sorrows and at the same time trying to find happiness. And I can't believe how many people have been joining into the sessions and the online davening. And thank you to Rabbi Walker and all of her technical expertise in getting us here on Zoom. We're changing the name outside the shul. I saw them painting it today. They're calling it the Beth David Ben Israel Beth Zoom congregation. And it's just been, you know, with the support of Rabbi Scheim and Ian Bohrer and Andy Pasco and the executive and the management, we've really managed to pull a lot of things together that I would have never dreamed we could possibly ever happen. So many of you were supposed to celebrate weddings, bar mitzvahs. People have had funerals. I've stood by the graveside all by myself, just me and no one from the family, saying prayers with the family on Zoom. And it's been very, very rough and very sad. And concerts canceled all over the world. In fact, I spoke with David Warwick today, and he was telling me that all of the plans and all the concerts that they've written shows for are canceled all over the world. And it's just been one of those things. So anyway, thank God that all of you that are here now have your health, and I have my health. And as you can see, we don't have the champagne, and we don't have the hors d'oeuvres, and we don't have the fancy tuxedo, and I'm in a plaid shirt, but l'chaim to everyone. And Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Shehakol Nieh Bidvaro L'chaim, and everybody good health, and we have to say Amen to that. Just me and a guitar, my buddy. It's not Lucille, but it's a guitar. You see, my hair's going out of the side of my head. I feel like Bozo the Clown. I didn't get my machine yet. It didn't come, so I haven't even had a chance to cut my hair.
Amen. Marshall.
Michael, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here by yourself?
Man, I didn't think you were showing up. You must be teaching.
What are you singing these sad songs for? Come on. You gotta put a smile on your face.
Sad songs, mad songs. Listen, you know, it's been terrible. I mean, what do you want me to do?
You think this is bad? You should read about the disease, desolation, and pestilence in this week's Parsha. This is nothing.
The Parsha. Always the Parsha.
But let's sing something a little more happy.
Okay.
All right. Hello, everybody.
We just happen to have a microphone here for him, just in case he shows up.
But you never knew who had it.
Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile, and maybe tomorrow, you'll see the sun come shining through for you.
So light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile. The use of crying, life is still worthwhile if you'll just smile.
Smile, your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by. If you smile through your fear and sorrow, smile, and maybe tomorrow, you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you'll just smile.
I feel better already. You know, the thing that gets me, Michael, is that every time someone phones me with their tzuras and I'm listening to everybody's tzuras, I'm thinking to myself, I'll have another drink and the tzuras will go away. But it doesn't go away. You have another drink, the tzuras comes back. You have another drink, that's the only one that's making any money right now is the liquor stores. So I don't know what to do. But if you've got the answer.
Well, Marshall, my friend, I know, unfortunately, kind of like the COVID-19, the answer is probably blowing in the wind.
Oh, God, I've heard that one before.
All right, let's give it a shot.
How many roads must a man before you call him a man?
Yes, and
how many seas must a white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand?
Yes,
and how many times must the nightingales fly before they're forever blowing in the wind? The answer is blowing in the wind. And how many years must a mountain exist before it is washed to the sea?
Yes.
How people exist before they're allowed to be free? And how many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. And how many times must a man look before he can see the sky.
Yes.
And how many ears must one man have before he can hear people cry? And how many deaths will it take till he knows that too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
That you showed up. That's a lot better than being all by myself. Oh my goodness!
David, what are you doing here?
I saw your car in the parking lot. What are you doing here?
You just came for the drinks.
Well, I live close by.
David, it's amazing. David Wark, ladies and gentlemen, the great talented David Wark just happens to be here. And just in case you'd show up, I set up a keyboard for you and an amp because I thought you never know,
guy.
Just in case.
What a guy. What, so you guys
I hope
sing here
we
every
can see
night?
Well, we don't sing every night. We just sing...
we usually sing on the computer, but tonight.
Oh, okay.
David, do you know the song "All Col Ale"? It's it became synonymous in 1967 with the Great War in 1967. It was associated also with the 1982 war in Lebanon. And since that time, Naomi Shemer, one of her most beloved songs, became "Al Kol Ela." And it's just as meaningful today as when it was first composed. And I thought we'll sing "Al Kol Ela" together.
Beautiful.
You got the music for it?
Just happens.
All right.
Just glad happens to have the music
all right,
for it.
Nice.
Al hadvash ve al haokets, al hamar ve hamatok, al biteinu hatinoket shmoreli hatov, al haesh hamevoeret, al hamayim hazakim, al haish hashav habayta min hamerchakim, al kol eile. Oh,
Beautiful. You know,
thank you, David.
I want to tell you a little bit about the day today. So I came in to set up the chapel and to put a few things here. And it was freezing. And right now we're freezing in here. Our hands are so cold. It's 58 degrees in this room because there's no heat in the shul because we've turned the boiler off, which makes a lot of sense. We're trying to save you money out there. And we're sitting here right now in 58 degrees. And that's why I'm wearing a woolly, but I got long underwear on too. And
put on a pair of gloves already.
Gloves, yeah, too much information. And I actually had to wear gloves today. So anyway, as we were setting up all of the stuff today, what happened was I put a heater in the room, one of those little space heaters, and it blew the circuit breaker. So I went into the back room and I was in the dark and trying to find the dark, which circuit breaker was off. And finally we got that working again. And then 5 minutes before we were about to start at 7:25, I'm in here opening up my computer and I had no internet access. So you were all going to have a show without me, but I all of a sudden, thanks to Michael's ingenuity and Rabbi Walker, we got everything going. And here we are. And I'm just going to look at the computer. I want to see how many people are here tonight for this beautiful evening.
He didn't mention that when he was fumbling around in the dark in the back, he accidentally found his way inside the Kiddush Club liquor cabinet.
So there's 188 participants on, and many of you I know are two and three people. So I'm guessing there's 250, 300 people on here tonight, which really makes me happy because I said to David, we might get, 50, 60 people coming on? But there's like 300 people here.
That's amazing.
It is amazing. Beautiful. So thank you to everyone for sharing time with me as we do on Wednesdays. And everybody knows the song by the Beatles, Let It Be. Well, Naomi Shemer composed her own version of that called Lu Yehi. And we're going to sing that. Michael's going to sing it for you.
Od yesh mi fras lavan ba'ofek mul anan shachor kaved kol shenevakesh lu yehi ve'im b'chalonot ha'erev orvadot ha'chag roe kol shenevakesh lu yehi lu yehi lu yehi ana lu yehi kol shenevakesh lu yehi lu yehi Notani shomea kol shofar vekol tupim kol shenevakesh lu yehi shama achad libi kol shenevakesh lu yehi lu yehi lu yehi ana lu yehi kol shenevakesh Shuna ktana mutzelet bayit kat im gag adom kol shenevakesh lu yehi ze sof hakayit sof haderech ten lahem lashuv halom kol shenevakesh lu yehi lu yehi lu yehi ana lu yehi kol shenevakesh Tom Yisrach Neofel Al Roshenu Or Kochav Kol Shenevakesh Lu Yehi shalvavet ein gam koach lechol eile shenohal kol shenevach eish lo yehi lo yehi lo yehi ana lo yehi kol shenevach eish lo yehi lo yehi lo yehi ana lo yehi kol shenevach eish lo
song.
I do as well. And you know, when you sing Lo Yehi, if only it were, it should only be like that, let it be. I'm looking around at the photographs that everybody sent here into the chapel. And when we're singing here, it's a little bit tough to see all the faces on the computer from so far away. But when I look at these faces here on in the chapel, it reminds me of everybody's got a smiling face here, the photos they sent in. And I imagine everybody there on the computer is also smiling. So hopefully that continues to keep us inspired and motivated to do everything that we're doing to maintain a sense of community these days. So thanks to everybody, not just for sending those photos, but for participating and continuing to be part of our congregation.
You know what else, Michael? You know what it reminds me of? How the whole thing started in the first place. I was thinking, I'm celebrating 20 years coming up at the shul, and I wanted to do a concert, but I wanted to do the concert that people could participate from our shul, and I know they're participating right now with us. But what I wanted for them to do was to be part of the concert and be part of the, what I called Makom Kavua, honoring their space in the chapel. Right now, as I look around at all the faces filling the chapel, I'm thinking of their Makom Kavua. I see everyone's spot, everyone's place here in the chapel as it is in the sanctuary as well. And it reminded me how the dedications were coming in, and I was working to ask people in the congregation to dedicate a pew plaque so that when they come to shul, they can sit in that space and know that God knows that they're in that space. And also to participate in the Haftorah project, because the Haftorah project and putting in and beautifying it with all those beautiful illuminations that were going in are, is also a beautiful reason to be active in the shul as well. And I'm thinking as we sit here tonight, it's important to mention that that hasn't stopped. I mean, all of your support is so needed more now than ever before. And I can see your support, and I know that you're there for us as we are trying so desperately hard to be there for you. But please, if you haven't yet considered, call Michael. Call Michael and sponsor an illumination for the Haftorah so when we're all reading from it, we can see the beautiful illuminations above every single one of those Haftarot. And also, when the time comes, and it'll come soon, when we're all together in the sanctuary, I'd like to see everyone have a shining plaque with their name on it, or someone that they love's name on that plaque in that sanctuary. So when you come back, you remember the times that we couldn't be here. We couldn't be here together to daven together, and we'll be so grateful for that moment and that cherished moment that we are once again together. So please, consider those as being part of the Beth David family, because we really are truly a family.
You know, Marshall, I'm glad you mentioned the Haftarah project, because believe it or not, I just happen to have the Haftarah scroll here.
Wow.
And we haven't seen it in a long time. So I'm going to open it up to this week's Parsha,
do that,
just so they can see
I
one of those illuminations.
That would be amazing. And while Michael's doing that, I just wanted to mention another project, just so you should know, in case for Rosh Hashanah, when we're going to be live streaming, we have our management looking after making sure that we will be live streaming, and we'll have that. We're working on that really hard now to make sure that we have all of the equipment in place to make it really, really good under the circumstances. But live streaming costs money, and it costs between $10,000 and $15,000, and I just want to say that I'm giving the first $1,000 to that project. I'd like everyone to please consider trying to come up with something to help out so we can make that happen here at Beth David. So, Michael, show them the scroll. Wow, that's amazing. Michael, beautiful. I want everyone to consider that beautiful illustration and know that so many of those Haftarot in that scroll do not have illuminations. They're empty. There's empty spaces, and we want to really try and fill up every single space so they'll look as beautiful as that. Anyway, you know what I remember is one of my fondest memories in shul is when we have the time and we sing Avinu Shabbat Shemayim together, the prayer for the state of Israel. Everybody joins in and everyone sings. So Michael, join me. David, let's sing Avinu Shabbat Shemayim together so that the audience can sing along and participate.
Continue, Cantor Loomer. I just wanted to make a special mention. As most of you know, LaG BaOmer is a bit of an opportunity to transition from a time where it's kind of half mourning during the 33 days of the Omer, the first portion. And LaG BaOmer is an opportunity to do things that we haven't had a chance to do before, whether it's a haircut, a bar mitzvah celebration, and even a wedding. And
I need a haircut badly. Badly, I need a haircut.
You wish. Anyway, I just want to mention, somebody mentioned to me this morning that their parents were married on LaG BaOmer. There may be others in the congregation whose parents, grandparents were married in LaG BaOmer. So I want to wish a mazal tov to Barbara Kochberg, whose parents were married, I don't know how many years ago it was, but mazal tov and wonderful memories of your parents.
It's freezing in here.
What about me?
It'll warm you up.
Will this improve my playing? That's your cup over here. One second, Michael. Here's, there's a brand new one here for you. Well,
you can all pull out your bottles at the same time.
Everybody go get a drink because L'chaim, L'chaim, Tov Shalom. Well, very dear person in our family said to me the other day, we were having a conversation, everything today is on Zoom, and it was Mother's Day, and we thought, well, we'll do what everybody else is doing, we'll do a Zoom Mother's Day. And I had the strangest request. She said, is Moon River in your repertoire? And I said, of course, no. And Moon River is really not in my repertoire, but there's always room to add, and to the thousands of songs that that you and I have played together, David, I thought maybe you know that one and we could do that.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, this is for you, Barbara.
Moon River, wider than a mile, I'm crossing you in style someday. Old dream maker, you heartbreaker, wherever you're going, I'm going your way. Two drifters off to see the world, there's such a lot of world to see.
Are probably going nuts at home. And you know who's going the most nuts? Are the wives. They get the husband out of the house already. For God's sakes, he's making me crazy. Go back to work, go anywhere, go shopping, put a mask on. I don't care if the stores aren't open.
I just get sent.
Go anyway, go stand in line, put a mask on and stand in line. But the barbershop's not open. Don't worry, it'll open in 3 months, but go stand there already. So to my wife, Laura, who puts up with all of my chazarai and all of my shtick, she should hear this word. Love changes everything. This is for you, Laura.
love. Love changes everything, hands and faces, earth and sky. Yes, love. Love changes everything. Hope you live and how you die. Love can make the summers fly or the nights like a lifetime. Yes, love. Love changes everything. Now I tremble at your name. Nothing in the world will ever be the same. Love, love changes everything. Days are longer, words mean more. Yes, love can break the strongest hearts. Pain is deeper than before. Yes, love will turn your world around, and the world will last forever. Yes, love, love changes everything. Brings you shame. Nothing in the world will ever be the same. Off into the world we go, planning futures, shaping years. Yes, love bursts in and suddenly all your wisdom disappears. Love makes full of everyone all the rules we make are broken. Yes, love. Love changes everything, live or perish in its flame. Yes, love will never, never, never be the same. Love will never, never, never be.
You always could play that one, David.
I love that.
Great number. So if you look at the Siddur, which you do every single morning, one of the first things in the Shemona Esrei, right after the Avodah, says, Atachonein la'adam da'at umlameid la'nosh bina, that we thank God for giving us a seichel and a mind, and that we should use it and keep and have all of our wisdom. But we have to thank God for the wisdom. And you and I, we got the gray hairs to prove it.
We do indeed.
Yeah. So I'm going to sing you a Hasidic medley of Atachonein. Everyone together. This is for the Chazonis lovers. But I'm looking at this, and I just have to read some of this that's being written here. David, you got to hear this. Okay, someone said, when are you going to sing Moon River already? Okay. To Alan and Penny, can't hear anything. From Rabbi Walker, amazing. I can hear, amen. Lovely, Marshall. Nice to see you, Michael. We should all sing along. From Brenda. From Barry Cutler. My, it sounds like you two have sung together before. This is so wonderful. From Anita Sherman. They are the famous Two Moishas, Brenda. You guys sound great together. You guys, okay, the original version of this was done by our executive director and our VP of ritual, Ian and Sylvia, Igor, to everyone. From 10 Election, this voice keeps cutting out. Oy vey. Super, you are boosting all of our morale. Miss you, but full points on including all of us. Thank you from the Dworkins. Seems like it might be a minor Wi-Fi issue. Oh, I hope that you're still hearing some of it. Can you hear me at all? I don't know. All right. You guys are great. A very beautiful concert, gentlemen. Well done. How much does it cost? Wonderful concert. I will also contribute towards this wonderful project. From Barry Levine. Oh, good. Barry, amazing. Thank you. Thank you for all being part of this concert and for your support of Bette David. From Libby, Libby and I will also be part of the Haftorah project. We encourage others in the Bette David family to do so also. Amazing, beautiful concert. How do we make a contribution to the project? Call Ian Borer at the office, call Michael Rubin. Very beautiful, thank you. So I want to thank all of you for your comments. And so with our family in Toronto, from Howard Gans, and Faye, great job from the K's, and thank you. And it's just beautiful to see all the messages from everyone. So that's great. David, do we have more songs? We have a couple more songs to do? We'll do a couple more.
What do we have? Wonderful World. That's it? So,
we're going to finish off with a beautiful song, and everyone knows the song.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world, wonderful world. I see skies of blue
and clouds of white, the bright blessed day,
the dark sacred nights. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky.
They're also on the faces of the people going by. I see friends shaking hands.
You should play a solo, David. What a wonderful world. So pretty in the sky.
They're also on the faces of the people going by. I see Frank shaking hands. They're saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I miss you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world, what a wonderful world. Thank you, everyone. Chag Sameach, happy LaG BaOmer. Look forward to seeing you in the Minyanim. I love all of you. Bye.